Hello to you. My name is Maria Kondzielska and this is Poland Daily Culture. Have you ever heard about Tamara Wimpicka? I do hope you have. And with me in the studio is Grzegorz Musiał, the author of this biographical novel about no one else but this great artist, Tamara Wimpicka. Thank you very much for being here with us.
Thank you for the invitation. I'm very glad to be here.
And I was gobsmacked, and it's really fascinating book. And of course, it is also a fascinating character of Wimpicka. I would say lots of mysteries and a lot of untrue information out there, because I would say every single group wants Tamara to be on their side. So first of all is that I know that you're professionally a doctor and that you're performing your occupation as a doctor, and in free time you worked on this novel, and it's very well written, with rich language and with huge amount of information. So my question is, because how did it happen that you fell in love with Tamara Wimpicka? Because one needs to be in love in order to write such kind of book.
Definitely, and I could answer your question very accurately, because I remember the day, I remember the year and all circumstances of my first meeting with Tamara Wimpicka in my life, and my falling in love with her, exactly as you said, falling in love with her. It was London, summer 1975, and the exhibition of her paintings arrived in London from Paris, because Tamara Wimpicka was rediscovered as a great painter again after decades of total oblivion in 1973. Her first big exhibition after the Second World War in Europe took place in Paris, in Galerie Luxembourg, arranged by a student of fine arts. Him and his group of friends from the Department of Fine Arts in Paris find out that there was someone called Tamara Wimpicka back in the 30s. They saw her paintings in the album, and they fall in love with her immediately. And they arranged an exhibition for the opening of their own little private gallery, which is now quite famous, Galerie Luxembourg. It was, as I said, 1973. And this was explosion of enthusiasm in Europe and throughout the world when she was rediscovered, and Parisians didn't know that they had such treasure, you know, in their history, such a painter, amazing painter. And this exhibition went on to London 3 years later. So I was in this year, 1975, in London. And this was exactly when I was changing trains on the Charing Cross Road station in London, because I was working as many students from Poland back then. I was 20 years old, just that. And I was changing trains because I was going to my kitchen in Knightsbridge to wash dishes, because this was the way we earned money, you know, for our journeys in Europe in 1970s. Coming from Poland, you know, from our departments, university departments, to wash dishes in London and then travel across Europe again. So I was changing trains to Knightsbridge, and I suddenly went out of my Northern Line train, and I went to the tube, as you know, the tube stations in London. It's a long, long tube. And suddenly I'm surrounded with her face, everywhere her face on the walls. As long as the tube goes ahead of you, you see only her sitting behind this famous driving wheel with those, you know,
gloves,
yes, and that look of a lady who knows
what she wants.
What she wants, yes, exactly. And there's like hundreds of her faces around me. And I was just standing like this, oh my God, I'm in love with that woman. Who is she? Because I have to emphasize one thing. She was totally forbidden back then in Poland.
Why?
Her name was absolutely erased because she was anti-communist.
I see.
And she represented
Tamara Wimpicka,
yes,
was not known in Poland.
She declared herself as absolutely anti-communist. Secondly, she was also the member of the most hated social class ever for the communists, because she belonged to the upper class from the very beginning of her life to the very end of her life. And she demonstrated
her
belonging to it, you know, because it was the class which was the main number one enemy of the communist system. And she just obviously declared her belonging to that class, her anti-communist attitude, absolutely. So they hated her.
So no one at the Academy of Fine Arts in Warsaw in 70s or 80s talked about Tamara.
I'm surprised to have had such experience many times that I spoke to people, but not many times, a few such cases, when I spoke to the people whom I considered, you know, well informed about the history of art. Professionals who just like, oh, well, yes, I think I know who you are talking about. I have to say exactly, to be fair, when it was. It was like when I came back to Poland and I started speaking with people, because now the knowledge is much broader about her. It was back then, 20 years ago. And those people didn't know anything about her. The people, the professionals from the high...
Even the professionals from Poland didn't know anything about
her.
Yes,
in Poland, nobody did.
It's such a ridiculous wheel of fame and fortune when she was definitely an exquisite, amazing artist and known very well also later right now outside Warsaw, in the whole world, in US, in Paris, in Mexico. Mm-hmm. And people in Poland didn't know much about her. I do hope that because of your book, this knowledge, this broader knowledge, will go basically to every single house, because it's a beautiful book. It's not only, it's not a biography, it's a novel. So it's easy to read, it's easy to sink into the story and with the, like, led with you by a hand to fall in love with Tamara.
I'm happy to hear that from you, because that was exactly my idea to write. Why the novel? That's the question I'm often asked. Why don't you just write the biography? No, because she has already had a few biographies, like the one written by Laura Claridge, the professor in the United States, who is the author of the basic, I would say, biography of Tamara, very detailed, very, very well done. And this was written in 2000, about this time. Now republished in Poland again, because the first edition was in 2000, and now is the new edition, which has the much broader now response of the audience. But back then, in the 2000, nobody knew who this book was about. So this was a really important book, you know, to have the knowledge about her, the details of her life. I wanted to write the novel because I want to know the details of her soul. I'm not that much interested in what kind of what color of dress she had on her walking to Café de Margaux in Paris on, I don't know, 3rd of May 1927, you know, for example. This is not important. So of course, it is important for the biographer, not for a writer, because her feelings, her idea, spiritual idea, is more important for me. And this is possible only with the means of a novel writer.
I absolutely agree, and I do hope that the audience of Poland Daily also understand this approach. And if you are looking for something exquisite, and especially if you are very interested in art, biography, Me, Tamara, written by Grzegorz Musio, is a must read for you. And thank you very much for watching Poland Daily Culture.